doing, that's going to change. And we're 28th in the league in that category. Here's a drive from the line that goes wide. Red Wings trying to set this power play up again with 46 seconds to go on the man advantage. Svechnikov played it around for Smith. Giovanni Smith on the boards, hands it off to Joe Higgins. Comes back in front. Here's a chance. Scores! Billy Sariani with a power play goal, and it's 1-0 Detroit. Chips it off the boards in the corner. Vincent Laverde goes after, throwing in front. Glendinning with a chance right on, and McElhinney makes a stop. Engvall trying to fish it over to Joris. Broken up. Matt Pumpel the other way. Tees it up. Stopped by McElhinney. Both at 6-1 on their records in the preseason. Dominic Turgeon cuts it off. Gets it back. Turgeon scores! Dominic Turgeon. A shorthanded goal. And it's 2-0 Detroit.
I think Turgeon's got a chance to be a good player in this league at some point.
Pierre Engvall trying to settle it down. Engvall checks up, goes to the point. Ball fires. That went through the pads of Bernier. Dangerous play for Evgeny Svechnikov. He's hurt. He went feet first into the end boards, and you heard him holler. And he is hobbling his way, trying to get back to the Detroit bench right now. Can't get it. Back of the goal for Zadina, but then Zadina skates over to take it away from Marincin. Philip Zadina curling away from Gauthier. Dumps it out for Turgeon. Turgeon has a look around on Ned, knocked down by McElhinney. Joris off the boards. Marincin tries the one-timer and his stick breaks, and now he's got to hustle back. 3-on-2 Red Wings. Svechnikov to the slot, shoots, and it's stopped by McElhinney. And the Red Wings turn it the other way. Sariarvi with it. Tried to pass across off the skate of Branko Šulák with a drive, and that one missed. Vincent Laverde, long pass, Grundstrom, 2-on-0 breakaway. Grundstrom pass, gets it back, scores! What a give and go with Adam Brooks and Carl Grundstrom, and the Leafs are on the board.
And what a pass by Laverde. I mean, a beauty tape to tape that completely caught the Red Wings standing still. As both defensemen here just gamble in.
Tangled up with Dylan McArath, and Joe Hickett springs Martin Furk. He'll snap one on net, and McElhinney had it on the top of his pad, and he'll put the glove on it to get a whistle. And slow to go to the bench here is Richard Kroon for the Leafs as he just makes it there with a puck going by his skates in front.
You know, this group of players for the Leafs right now have had probably no power play time together.
Darren Helm, shorthanded, puts it off the goalpost. Back down, and now Borgman will back up with Pumpel watching. Works it up ahead for Clark. He's pressured. Pumpel hands it off. Here's Giovanni Smith with a shot kicked away by Curtis McElhinney. Smith curling with it. Lost a handle, but he's got support. And it scores! Matt Pumpel! Well, that's the support that he was looking for as Pumpel puts it in the top corner, and it's 3-1 Detroit.
Yeah, Pumpel's an intriguing player. He was a good junior in Peterborough. He's been moved around a lot. Ended up last year in Grand Rapids where he had 22 goals in 57 games.
So the Red Wings regain their two-goal lead. Philip Zadina fires it off the boards and in. McElhinney out of the net. Right around, Zadina's hurt at the blue line after a collision, and this will draw a lot of attention.
He's hurt too, oh boy. You hate to see that with a young player. He's going right to the locker room.
Not a good sign at all as Libor Šulák went into his defense immediately.
And you worry about young players coming in the National Hockey League. Are they ready physically? And I know this is a play that you don't like to see, and it could have happened to anybody. And that's a tough play for the youngster. He's back now on the bench, so that's good news.
Evgeny Svechnikov cut off on a check by Emerson Clark. And now a breakaway pass for Pierre Engvall. Going to the net, by Šulák.
No penalty. And the Leaf bench looking for one.
Puck
comes back to the point. Aronic will feed it across, gets it back. Red Wings set up the power play here. And a one-timer scores. Martin Ferk back of the net. 4-1 Detroit.
Now, it's funny how it works. Grenstrom ended up with a penalty right after that breakaway play, which in my opinion was a penalty. I was going to say that Jonathan Bernier apparently almost... Whoop.
And now a breakaway for Moore. Stopped by Bernier as that puck was sneaking right towards the goal line, and Bernier put his skate down and fought it off to keep it out.
John, I'm going to let you tell the helicopter story.
Turned over in front. Here's Helm and alone. Stopped by McElhinney and tight. Pilot license.
I know, I'm jinxed.
And he only has about 15 hours left. Right in tight. Stopped by McElhinney as Glendening tries to get it on net. And now Clark has got it with a shot on net. And the pilot makes a stop. Brooks being watched closely by Shulak. Borgman with a shot block. Luke Glendening hustles back the other way. Glendening to the net. Stopped by McElhinney.
But in saying that, those second rounders would look pretty good right now, wouldn't they? Look out.
Pass right in front, and Ferk put it off the outside of the goal. Back of the goal. We'll fire it off the glass and get it out, and that's a break for Pierre Engvall. Settles it down. Got the shot on that, and it's steered away by Bernier. Luke Glendening is there to turn back the other way. Got it ahead for Darren Helm. Helm goes to the net. Wrap around, and it's stopped by McElhinney.
That's 27 seconds for the third period.
Cracknell, all on top of his man. Puck is underneath the pile somewhere, and now we'll get a whistle. And back up to his feet and taking exception is Josh Juris to the extra cross check from Dylan McElrath, and that's going to draw some extra attention here. Gets to the Detroit zone. Mikaeli Rosen was already in, and that ends up being an offside, and now we've got... Wow, more extracurricular activity.
It's making it a little ugly here with 10 minutes to go in a 4-1 game.
Hands it across for Hall. Hall gains his zone. Now Cracknell with it. In front, and a great chance for Rosen over a stick. Shulak gets the long pass, and he's in alone. Shulak scores! Shulak out of the box and buries it to make it 5-1 Detroit.
Yeah, break for the Detroit Red Wings here. Shulak, the penalty's expired. And now we got a fight going. This has been coming for a while.
And it's Emerson Clark and Luke Witkowski. And Clark, a few inches shorter, but trying to make the best of it. 5'10 against Witkowski, who's 6'2. And Emerson Clark made an impact all through training camp for the Maple Leafs and through the preseason. And that'll do it. Now poked loose, and Colin Greening will go catch up to it. Greening in front for Gauthier with a chance. The Leafs will finish the preseason with a 6-2 record. The Red Wings 7-1, and they'll get a hand here in Detroit for a 5-1 win.
Well, the Red Wings with a few more NHL players in the lineup tonight, and it showed. Meanwhile, for many of these Leafs, they will get going with the Toronto Marlies and continue to work on their craft to try and make the big team at some point in their career.